One second, I think he needs to grab something.
Okay. See, I was trying to tell him who this is the guy presently following, Yogaraj Gurnath, and there's another picture of me with him there.
Yes.
See that.
Is Gurnath.
Yeah, Gurnath. And then the guy that's dead. Paramahansa Yogananda. Anyway, so I made a lot of work for you because I didn't know how to answer those questions. So I apologize.
It's okay. Not to worry. It's okay. Thank you. If you're ready, we're ready. Mm-hmm.
அறுபதனை அணியாக கொண்டு நின்று அங்கமதில் இடமாகும் எனக்கு மீது உரத்திலிவேன் காலைவனை பலாவலனை.
This is the prayer by Shiva Vakya Maharishi. So the Maharishi who wrote a palm leaf is Shiva Vakya. He prays to Lord Shiva and Parvati. Shiva Vakya Maharishi. He is one of the great sages. Out of 18 Maharishi, Shiva Vakya Maharishi is one of the great sages who wrote your palm leaf. And today he prays to Lord Shiva and Parvati. So two energies have a blessing of Shiva and Parvati. Two of them blessing you're having. So Shiva and Parvati's blessing for it to get here.
Just to make sure that Bill understands, Shiva Vakya Maharishi is the saint that wrote your palm leaf. You know, the bundle was written by him, every single palm leaf in it. And he received the message for you by meditating to Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati. So you got the blessings of these three for today's reading.
So this Shiva Vakya Maharishi's prediction a bit different from the other Maharishi. Comparing other Maharishi, Shiva Vakya Maharishi a bit unique. The reason because his prediction or his guy is a kind of narration. Narration means like a story or giving a kind of speech, like a speech like this to give a guidance for us.
So Shiva Vakya, the way he writes his messages are a little different to the other Maharishis, the 17 others. It gives it like a speech, a direction.
So before telling your prediction, Maharishi gives some identifications. The first identification is your thumbprint. It has a category name. Your category is Urusuri Magudam Reha.
Now talk about your thumbprint name, sir, which Shyam is typing into the chat. Urusuri Magudam Rehai. That is the name of your thumbprint and it's written in the chat.
Already there are four dots. Four dots are open for you. Now the fifth dot is also in process to open the fifth dot for you. Might be in the past it was open, but right now it is average.
Wow. So you have already four dots open. Yeah. Average person only has three dots open. And your fifth dot is in the process of opening up. Amazing.
Might be in the past, might be open, but right now it is weak or invisible.
So your fifth dot might already have been open, but at the moment it's either weak or invisible. But you have the potential for five. The average.
So the meaning of a thumbprint is Uru. Uru means one, sir. There is one energy. Suri means circle. There is an energy circle. So your life circle, a kind of.
Uru means one and Suri means circle. So one circle.
It represents for some kind of power, ability, or some kind of skill. That means those who have this kind of orosuri, high knowledge, intelligent will be. So for you, you're a very skilled person. High knowledge, graduation, education, creative knowledge, advising ability. You have a good ability to heal others by your advice, counseling, teaching. So high creative knowledge you have based on the suri.
Do you understand, sir? Or should I repeat?
Repeat.
Repeat. Okay, so Urusuri is one energy or one circle, one power. Those people that have this particular thumbprint name have high knowledge, are intelligent and also the power to heal and guide other people. Mm-hmm. So you have a highly evolved spiritual wisdom within you. You are an educated man. And with this power that you have, you can help and heal others. Uru Suri, one, there's one big energy in you. They're all uniting, as opposed to two energies that will be a different reading altogether. But yours is one. And Shiam, just to make sure, I would need to repeat everything to Bill because he has a hard time understanding you, okay? So you need to put a pause a little bit, then I repeat, and then we can continue. Thank you.
The second part is called Maguda. Maguda means it's a special kind, a kind of crown. Maguda means crown. So it can be spiritual crown, can be opening the high chakra, Kundalini, chakra or crown. Maguda means leader. So it has a different meaning.
So magudam means crown. It's either it could be a spiritual crown on top. That means a spiritual master or leader connected to the universe.
Crown chakra, connected.
It is also representing your crown chakra, the seventh chakra.
So like a crown, like a maguda.
And you can see Magudam in the background on the poster. You see, she's wearing a Magudam.
That means there is a specific ability in that you are a king. So there is no one who is higher than you, like the ability. You are the master, superior, or supreme person. It can be writing, arts, pressure. You're a master, like this high position.
So in what you do, you're a master. Having this conference name, you in your field, you are a leader. There are not many that are quote unquote above you. You are reaching the top of your field.
In your thumbprint, there are four dots. Other sir, the first dot, education, career, profession, spirituality. Good dot.
There are four dots in your on your thumbprint. The first one that we're going to talk about is about your education, spirituality. Yes.
The second dot represents your family. That means your health, money, property, family. We can say almost positive, but based on your parents are a bit weak because they are not living, not alive now, but almost the second dot also positive for you.
So the first dot that we talked about, your education, spirituality, is good. Very good. Very open, 100% positive. The second one dot that we're talking about now is about your health, your family, parents. That's almost 100% positive. The reason why it's not 100% is that, for example, your parents have already passed on.
And no,
otherwise, it is perfect.
And also no real sibling, only half sibling.
Yeah, and also because you don't have full siblings, only half siblings. That's the only reason why the second dot is not 100%. But in reality, it's very good. It's perfect. Yes.
Mm-hmm. The third dot represents your relationship, marriage, and kids. We can say it's positive. Related to children is good. Related to your partner, wife is good in your life.
So the third dot represents your relationship, your marriage, your kids, and you can say that in general, also very good.
And the fourth dot connected to social life, maybe social service or social life, what you dedicate yourself towards the people, helping the people, guiding the people, serving, social work. So it is positive for the fourth dot.
So the fourth dot, which represents your social life, your social work, you dedicating yourself to others and helping others is also very good, highly evolved and strong.
That means you connect yourself with the other people or in the universe. But there is a fifth dot also, which is right now is...
The fourth dot means that you give yourself to others, you connect with other people. So that's perfect. But there is also a fifth dot, which at the moment is invisible or very weak.
The fifth dot we call connected to new elements. It can be connected to elements, connectivity with the different planets, connecting with the different supreme energy. It is a kind of blockage, Caesar. That means there is not only the duty to help the people, there is also universal work. That means some kind of work to heal the universe. It can be connecting with the five elements, elements connecting yourself or connecting yourself to whatever.
Hold on, Shyam. So the fifth dot, which at the moment has a little block on, is the dot that connects you with animals, the supreme power, or other planets. And that goes beyond helping other people. It's more on a global realm than the direct help of other people. And there is, it's at the moment, it's a little weak or invisible. Yes, Shyam, continue.
Usually the fourth dot is connected what your energy, what you have giving to others. But you need to feel this energy. You need to connect to feel this energy. Right now it is a bit blocking. But in the past there was some connectivity, some kind of information, transformation, receiving some kind of intuition or channeling which you give for others. But right now it is one way. The path is one way which you give for others. But what you receive, what you connect in reverse, it is blocking.
And that's the fourth dot, Shyam, or the fifth dot?
Fifth dot, it is blocking.
So the fifth dot is blocked, yeah, but they said the fourth dot is good because he gives to other people. But before, he was also connected to the universe, receiving energy and messages, filling up the vessel, so to speak. But at the moment, that connection is missing. Correct, Shyam?
In other way, it is a reverse or reflection. It is a reflection or reverse energy. What you do, you need to get the feedback, you know, it's a giving energy, reflection of energy. What you give, it is to have the reflection of energy is weak. The fifth dot is connected to the reflection, the energy.
Okay, so what you give is perfect, but what's missing is for you to receive. That portion at the moment is missing.
So anyway, Mahatmanakti Thottunda.
You're born on 16th March 1946, you're born, sir.
You're born on March 16th, 1946.
Hi, Mark.
The day which you're born is Saturday. So you're born on Saturday, sir.
You're born on a Saturday.
Your moon sign is Leo, sir. According to the Vedic, your moon sign, Vedic moon sign is Leo.
In Vedic astrology, moon sign is Leo.
The Lagna, ascendant is Sagittarius.
And in Vedic astrology, the ascendant is Sagittarius.
Now your age is 7. Huh? 75. Now your age is 75. So that means 74 completed. 75 is in process. Why?
You are in your 75th year.
So now we can say 75 is a blessing for you. By the Maharishi, is the right time or the blessing for you to get your leave. So again by Shiva Vakya Maharishi.
You have the blessing to receive your reading today.
Your Vedic birth star is called Puram. Puram is very good birth star. So those who are connected to Puram.
You have your birth star, sir, which is typed in the chat, is called Puram. And it's a very good birth star to have because those born under this birth star have
some kind of soft energy. Because in general, sir, Leo is called as a strong energy. Because like a main energy, very strong energy. And also Sagittarius is also very strong energy.
But so being born under Puram, it's a soft energy. So your moon sign Leo and the ascendant Sagittarius are very strong.
Strong energy.
So being born under the birth star of Puram, it softens it.
According to the Western zodiac says is Pisces zodiac.
According to Western astrology, you're Pisces.
It is also soft energy. So
Pisces is also soft
energy for you. It is not compatibility like this means your direction might be indifferent, not this artistic, but be indifferent.
What do you mean, sir? I don't understand you.
Might be those who are born under Leo or Sagittarius, they are called a fighter. They are strong, like a king, warrior, no strong. But your duty, you're also fighting, but in a different angle, in a soft way.
Now, those people are usually born under Leo and Sagittarius, which are very strong, fiery signs. they're fighter leaders, but because you're given this opening, Puram, birth star, and in Western astrology, Pisces, it softens it, and hence your energies are directed towards what you're doing now in a softer way, helping other people.
There is a saying, instead of a sword, the pen nib is more sharper. So you're using the pen, sharper. It's more sharper than the knife or the sword. So you're using it in a brilliant way. You're very using it in a good way. So that is your angle.
You understand, sir? Bill, did you understand?
It means the pen is more lighter than the sword. So the
did you understand, Bill, or no?
I'm missing a lot of it because my heart.
I repeat it all. I repeat it all for you. I repeat everything. So he says, given that you're born under Puram and your Western astrology is Pisces, instead of fighting with a sword, which you would had you been a pure Leo and Sagittarius, you're now using the softer tip of a pen. And with the pen, you're leading other people instead of fighting with a sword.
I like that
analogy. And the sword.
There will be some ups and downs. Always you need to, like pieces. Pieces connect a fish. Like a fish, always there will be a challenge. That means each moment you need to face some kind of new experience or obstacle, challenges, but you're overcoming. Each day there is a struggle, but you overcome it in a victory. Every time, stepping in a victory, success, but facing some struggles.
So given your thumb impression and your birth star and your zodiac, every day is a challenge, every day. But you can overcome the challenge. Like Pisces, ups and downs, the way they swim, fish. You do the same. You face a challenge, you overcome it, then comes the next, you overcome it, and so forth. This is
whatever the goal you have, which you're in your life, you will achieve it. So you're reaching your goal. Every time you keep yourself a destination, you're crossing, you're reaching it, you're succeeding it as a good leader. You're a leadership portion, you're having.
And because you have this leader gene in you, the Maguda, remember the crown. You set your goal and you achieve it despite obstacles and challenges. You get there.
So always you go in the right direction, truthful direction, or being more honestful direction, reliable direction, being true for others, being motivating others and guiding others towards the light or towards the truthful direction you're guiding the people.
So your way is to guide others in the right direction, help them, make them grow. You have a strong will, the power to guide other people toward the light, toward improvement.
Getting the palm leaf, your parents are not living, sir.
While getting your palm leaf red, your parents have already passed away.
Your name, Bill.
Your name is Bill.
Father name also the same name, Bill.
Your father's name is Bill.
Mother name, Marcella.
Your mother's name is Marcella.
For you, no real sibling, but for your half sisters you're having, and also half brother you're having.
You have no real siblings, but half sibling.
You're married, sir.
You're married, correct.
The wife's name is Carol.
The wife's name is Carol.
Two children for him. One son, one daughter for him.
You have two children, one son and one daughter, correct.
The children's life is good. So, but the last 2 years, a bit average for the children. There was a block, but might be in 41 or 42 days, even better situation will be there for the children.
Can you repeat this one more time, Shyam? Sorry.
Now your age is 75, sir. Your age is 75.
Yes.
It is a positive period. For you, it's good. You are in a good time. So for you, it is good. It can be your work, health, profession, almost, but sometimes some health issues, but which you can able to manage in this period, 75.
So now you are in your 75th year, and it's a good period for you in general. And you might have some minor overcome, and that's not a big issue. Understood, sir?
But for the children's, the last 2 years for the children's, for the son and daughter, for the both, that much not fine.
But for your kids, son and daughter, for the last 2 years, they were not so good.
There was obstacles, challenges, obstacles in their life. But these obstacles will recover or overcome in 41 days.
So they had to face some challenges and obstacles, your kids. But these challenges and obstacles will fade away in 41 days from today.
Especially for the son, the first son, three impact was there, but now one impact, Kedu's impact was resolved. But Saturn, planet Saturn, and Jupiter impact is remaining for the son.
Especially your son was impacted by this.
Saturn and Jupiter.
Three planets were impacting him.
Kedu,
Saturn and Jupiter. Saturn and Jupiter are physical planets. Kedu is a shadow planet, which means a planet without a physical body, but it still impacts us as if it were a real planet. Thank God the Kedu effect is already gone. Only two are left, Saturn and Jupiter, and they will eventually also go away within in 41 days from now. So things should improve for him.
41 days, Saturn, the planet Saturn, the long, that means which have two and a half years impact, will go into better for the child, for both. That means for the son also, after 41 days, better income, better possibility, good name, good fame will be there. For the daughter, now she's no proper work, house making will be there. For her also, she can also start something new as a kind of work after 41 days. Like the opportunities will be there for the daughter as well.
Okay, so these three planets have been impacting your kids for the past 2 years. Kedu, and you'd never want to be under the impact of Kedu or Saturn. They're big, bad buggers. Kedu is already gone. Saturn will go away in 41 days, which means the situation for your son will improve in general, his emotions, work-wise, stress levels. And also for your daughter, in 41 days, there is an opportunity, a possibility, if she wants to start something new outside of being a housewife.
For the partner, for the wife also, will be good in this. In this period, is good. But the last 1.5 years for the wife also, that much not strong, minor impact, a kind of skin, allergy, blood, hair-related problem for the wife. Now this problem is resolved. That means she's in a safe now.
So the last 1.5 years were not so good for your wife either. She had skin-related issues, health issues, head-related issues. What else was there, Shyam?
Blood, skin, allergy, impact.
Blood, skin, allergy, head-related issues. Head's eyes. But now the situation for your wife is also much better.
The next 1.5 years for the wife will be good. Good health, good relationship with you will be there.
And the next 1.5 years will be good for your wife and for the two of you, relationship with her.
The next 1.5 years for you, new opportunities, new work, new project, even run new articles or books writing, publishing situation is there for you, sir.
And also for you, the next 1.5 years, very good times, new opportunities. For example, writing a new book.
In the upcoming year future also, award, reward getting situation is there. But this award, reward after March 2021 will be there for it. Some kind of award, reward or recognition.
You might receive an award or reward next year after March of 2021.
More followers will be there in following your spiritual message or your guidance in this period.
And you'll have more followers of your spiritual guidance next year.
Guruvin Upadesathai un eluthaathathil urayatrinale nal maattangal kaanvaai.
You can do and write some kind of spiritual works, a spiritual connected writing situation is there in the coming year future you need to do.
So his duty is to do spiritual work, correct?
Yes.
So that's what Bill knows anyway. So that's what he's doing.
But right now, comparing before 2 years, the last two and a half years, your journey or your success is a bit average, sir.
Compared to 2.5 years ago?
Before, yes.
So compared to more than 2.5 years ago, at the moment, your success is average compared to those years back?
The last 2 years, there was how the children's had Saturn, Ketu, Jupiter, the same blocks for you was there, but minor. There was some minor block, the same block. Professional related, financial related, career related, business related, the same blocks for you, related to health-wise also.
So you were personally also impacted by these three planets, Saturn, Jupiter, and Ketu. So that means business was impacted, making money was impacted by this. But you are now overcoming those times and better times are upon you.
Even connected to head-related problem, confusion, stress also related to Ketu, but now it was resolved. Now Ketu's block was finished for you from the last 1 month. From the last 1 month, it is better. Again, you can start thinking. Sometimes there was a block in your thinking ability. You can't able to preserve what you think. A kind of brain or thinking related problem also was that. The last 1.5 years.
So the last 1.5 years, there was also some sort of a brain block or memory block. It was hard for you to remember things and follow through with them. But those times are over as well. Now the juices are flowing again. So things have shifted for you.
That means a kind of confusion. That means too much of information and confusion also the last 1.5 years. So he doesn't know what to preserve, what to write, or what to implement, what message to give for the people, like that the confusion, whether it is right, or sometimes your message will be controversial. Controversial message also situation will be there, whether to write this or not to write this, like the situation the last 1.5 years.
The last 2.5 years, Shyam?
Ketu, 1.5 years, but Saturn only 2.5 years, the block.
Okay, so let's go back to the last 2.5 years in general. There was confusion in you. You were not quite sure what to preserve and what message to bring across. You were not sure which is the knowledge that you need to preserve and a process and then pass on and which information you should just toss. But those times are over now and things are changing for you. Now, this is the perfect time, actually.
Sometimes there will be some kind of intuition, some knowledge or message to write or give, but later on you refuse not to publish. You might be writing it, but later on you decide not to call, because if you publish, it can spoil your previous reputation, like that also situation, which you had the last 1.5 years to 2 years.
So also you refuse to publish and put it into book form because this could have spoiled works that you've written before or spoiled your reputation. Hence, there was nothing. And now that you've been able to overcome these challenging times, now you're able to process, digest, and write things down again the way you want.
But the next 1.5 years started very good. Next 17 months, it is very positive information will be the channeling. That means next 17 months started channeling. So now onwards, 2020, 2021, and 2022, March 2022 until 17 months, there will be positive channeling. That means new information, new channeling is guiding. So there is something support you from the teacher, from the guru, teacher, philosophy, special exercise, way, channeling is going to happen.
So for the next 17 months, the channeling is working for you. So very fruitful times are upon you. From now till March 2022, that is.
Meditation, you can focus on the meditation and possibly reading books is essential, sir. Books, that means you are a writer, you're writing many books, you're legend. In writing books, you achieved a greater level being as a legend. But even though you need to be as a learner, learner to read books, to get new information, you are still a learner.
So then you should, despite the good times that are coming for you, you should meditate and also read books. Even though you're a high achiever in your field and a teacher, you should again become a student and learn more and get more information by being a student.
That means not reading a big books or novels. It can be small articles or small messages, newspaper, something. It comes new information from that book or some that thing, small thing, you can able to find out something bigger, which you can able to use in your book.
And by doing this research and becoming a student, you get new information that you can process and then put into your own books and pass on to other people. Yes, thank
you.
For you, after 20th November, more or less now, 22 days. After 22 days, there is some kind of opportunities is there for you. 22 days. New opportunities is coming for you connected to spirituality.
So from November 20th onwards, that's 22 days from now, new spiritual opportunities. There is an opportunity, a spiritual opportunity for you after November 20th of this year.
Because Jupiter is going to help you. Now, already the last 1 month, that means after 23rd September, Kedu, which is connected to Jnana, which opens the third eye chakra, started to open for you. So you can see the world in a different angle. So you can see the universe or the world, not ordinary, but in a different angle looking. You are an observer. You will be as an observer, but you will be observing this world in a different angle.
So you get, did you understand, sir? Or should I repeat?
Go ahead, give it to me. I might miss parts.
Okay. Jupiter, you get Jupiter's support in your new quest, which starts November 20th, you have already had the support of Kedu, the shadow planet, which is head related, and Jnana opening up your chakra, your wisdom chakra. You're able to see things as an observer, like the bigger picture, not the small things, but the bigger things. And this will help you after November 20th, not with your book, for example, with your endeavors.
Self-realization and jnana was already achieved by you. So that means the self-realization, what is your purpose, what is your duty, you already realized it and you are going in the right direction. And you already now achieved a jnana, what you know, what to do, and what is your future path, future life duties in this month.
So you've already achieved self-realization, the jnana, you know what you're supposed to be doing. You've already gotten to that point, and you know what to do in the future as well. So there is no confusion in you at all.
And Jupiter, after 22 days, Jupiter's strong energy will be. Jupiter is connected to Guru, so that means the energy of your Guru. Guru means it can be your spiritual teacher or the planet Jupiter, which is connected to education, profession, finance, who guides us towards the spiritual path.
Can you repeat this one more time, Shyam, please?
Guru, that means Jupiter positive energy is going to start in 22 days. Jupiter is a planet. Jupiter is generally helps us in finance. Good finance will be there. Education, new knowledge, education, and also spirituality. Our profession, it guides you in a good way. And also,
you need to slow down a little bit. So the planet Jupiter, as mentioned to you before, will start supporting you starting November 20th. And the planet Jupiter support is in finance, spirituality and education. It's like a
Something new, education. It can be you are going to give
education, finance, spirituality, yes.
Education or philosophy. Not as a teaching, but it's in a broader sense, it's like a philosophy. Giving a new philosophy will be there, but connected to spirituality. Might be spiritual divine secret, opening a spiritual divine secret towards the people, sharing your experience or sharing about the palm leaf, about the Maharishi's palm leaf also. Talking situation is there for you.
So there is an opportunity for you to share your philosophies about spirituality, about the Maharishis that you learned about today, about palm leaf readings per se, to spread the word and share it with the general public, because you get the support of the planet Jupiter.
Your spiritual master, you should also teach the philosophy or the advice or the teaching which you learn from your teacher, guru, means mentor, the same in a your angle. You need to include your message and you have to give it to the people in the future.
So you should also share the wisdom that you learned from your spiritual master. In your talks, spread the word.
The partner will be very helpful and very supportive in your life. Partner support you because...
And your partner will support you, your wife.
Support you in your life, like a backup, like a backup. That means as a backbone for you. So the wife is like a backbone in your life.
Always. Your wife is like your backbone of your life.
We see either your energy or your partner's energy with the divine energy. That means either you or your partner. Might be not from a human, but as an angel energy. One of them might be having an angel energy.
So you say that Bill or his wife have an
angel energy.
You have angel or
so
angelic
energy. Angel energy.
It's close to being an angel energy, Shyam.
No, not close. Having an angel energy, there is really God's energy is there for one of them. There is a divine energy is there for them.
So for one of the two of you, you or your
might
wife,
be both might be both also.
Might be both of you that have angelic energies in you.
Shiva Shakti,
like Shiva and Shakti, like Shiva Shakti, like Shiva and Shakti.
Like Shiva and Shakti.
That means two having one soul, one body, one soul, like a soulmate or soul energy, one energy. We call it an Arthanarishwar energy.
So they compared the two of you with Shiva and Shakti, like soulmates. Two people, one soul.
The reason because, sir. For us also, a bit it will be surprise what your life, because a bit surprised, because even though you have three blocks, you are somehow managed. It is impossible to manage like this to be in a marriage life or family life, but you have managed. That means you are not in a human level. You are beyond a human level. That is the reason might be you manage the block. There was three blocks, Sava Dosham, Mangala Dosham, Sarpa Dosham. Three block is in the marriage. So being together with this block, me being together with this family life or being together is impossible.
So they're saying that you have three big blocks. Three marriage blocks, actually, which makes marriage life impossible to other people. And yet you've been able to be married with this person for an eternity and have a family, which means that it's not a human thing. You're beyond human. Like you have a very evolved soul to be able to overcome the blocks and yet lead a successful family life, have a wife for such a long time and kids. So
Mars, Rahu, and Saturn.
The impact of Mars, Rahu, and Saturn is, go ahead, Shyam, sorry.
Mars is called Mangala Dosham, so, which is connected to marriage, called Mangala Dosham. Rahu, demon planet, Sarpa Dosham. Saturn called Dara Dosham. Three block is there.
So one of the planets, Rahu is again a shadow planet, Saturn and Mars. Mars is Mangala Dosham block, is family block. Saturn is Tara Dosham, and Rahu is Sarpa Dosham, which means also relationship and kids block, right, Shyam?
Kids block also is there, so it's also Putra Dosham is there, kids block is there.
Yeah, you also have a kids block on top of it, Putra Dosham.
Putra Dosham. And Putra also
Dosham. You know, block, no?
But Putra Dosham is caused by Keda. Might be for one of the child, head-headed problem will be the head or eye-headed problem for the one of the child will be the connected to Putra Dosham.
Okay, and because you not only have three, actually you have four major blocks, Ketu, shadow planet, negative, you don't want to be under the influence of Ketu, but you are, has an impact on children, so you have a child block too, but you overcame it somehow, which means the deduction is, the conclusion of this is, you must have a very evolved soul to be able to overcome these four blocks, which is an impossibility to a normal, not evolved human being, to have a marriage life and kids. The Keto block, which is the child block, you overcame, but it could mean that one of your kids has head-related issues or could have head-related issues.
No, with head, eye, nervous problem. One of the
head, eye, or nervous, anything that has to do with that, like depression, anxiety, migraines, could be, yes.
The last 2 years, the situation with you with the sun, a bit, there is some kind of energy, low energy is there, but this will improve in 42 days. After 41 days, with your son also, better relationship, better unity, family unity will be, with the daughter also, good unity, good relationship will be there.
Over the last 2 years, you also had a misunderstanding with your son. But in the next 42 days, after November, the next 42 days, that means in...
9th of December.
In December, that will fade away and your relationship with your son will improve.
So this 75, your age is now 75 and 76 will be a good situation, good changes will be there, more harmony, family unity, not only within the family, more people, unity among the people will be there, can be followers, friends, will be the students, will be there the next 1.5 years for you.
But now is your running age 75, meaning 74 in Western terminology, 76 running age, which means 75 in Western terminology, will be a good year for you, good family unity.
Healthy life, comparing now, you want
healthy life, yes.
Healthy life, 75, 76, even better healthy life will be, even the internal organ problem, digestion problem will be better for you.
So your internal organs will be okay, your health will be okay, relationship will be okay, it'll be a good year for you.
Chakras, new chakras opening will be there for you.
New chakras will open for you.
Your most powerful part in your body is your hand. So by your hand, it can be touch healing, blessing, writing, you can do. It is the most powerful part in your body.
The most powerful part of your body are your hands. You can do touch healing, or writing. Anything you do with your hands is very good. It's the most powerful part of your body.
You're born in a very special day called Saduti Day, you're born, which is connected to Ganesha. Ganesha special day, you're born, sir.
So you're born on Saturday Day, which is a very special day. It's Ganesha's day.
Ganesha is a block remover. That means you have ability to remove others' blocks.
And since Lord Ganesha is the block remover, you having been born on the same day, you have the ability to remove blocks for other people.
So the next book you need to write about some kind of divine secrets, how to protect ourselves from this virus or from this pandemic, from this confusion. It can be related to the fearness, the people's fearness, how to overcome the challenges, how to overcome over the fearness, how to develop the confidence. Like that, the motivational writing is essential for the people the next 2.5 years.
So the next 2.5 years, it said that you should write a book on about this pandemic and this virus, how to overcome the fear inside of you and motivate people, motivate them to overcome that fear.
And also to remove the selfishness. The most important to have a broader sense, unity to help each other, not be selfishness. You need to remove the selfishness. How to remove the selfishness and how to bring the brotherlyhood, the love, unity, harmony, and brotherhood relationship among the people.
And that book should also be to not be selfish anymore, but how to work in a collaboration, how to bring about the brotherhood energies.
And also you should write about the Kali Yuga, so the end of destruction. Kali Yuga, we are in the end of the life, end of destruction, Kali Yuga. And what is essential in this Kali Yuga to be more positive, how to be more truthful, lovable in this Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga, the year of destruction. So it is envious, which is spreading envious people, jealous, or wrong, bad energy, flu, virus, battery, how to protect ourselves and how to be more positive in this circumstance, in this Kali Yuga.
I think we need to explain a little more. There are four yugas, four, and we're now in Kali Yuga. We're at the tail end of Kali Yuga, and I think it's going to go another 30 years or so. No, it's almost the end of Kali Yuga. And your duty is to, or a calling could be, how to overcome the negativity, because Kali Yuga is the dark times, but the dark times are about to come to an end. How to motivate other people to come out of this negativity, how to help each other and lead a happier, more open, more collaborative life.
So you need to write. It is most important to write, sir, because for the goddess Saraswati, Saraswati's blessing is there.
So it's very important that you write. The most important thing is that you write, because you have goddess Saraswati, your blessing. So she's behind them.
They fell, behind, you can see goddess Saraswati. So goddess Saraswati is a goddess of education, arts, spirituality, creativity. So in this, it can be medicine connected. You need to help others.
So goddess Saraswati, who is on the picture behind Shyam, she's the goddess of education, arts, spirituality, medicine. So then you are under her influence. And as you can see, she's wearing the crown and you have the crown in your thumbprint name. And her support. So it's your duty almost really to write about these things.
Almost there will be good people, positive people will be there for your message, to receive your message, to appreciate you, to get the award. So 75 is people's appreciation. The award is none other than the people's appreciation, and they can get something in their life, which is very important. The people are in a suffering. So it is like the last tip of the water, which when they get in the last moment of their life for a survival. So like that, the stage, the people. So you need to give this water as a kind of message to overcome the block. It can be suffering, pain, or the confusions. So your guidance is very important in this period.
So as said before, your guidance and your writings are very important. It is kind of like the last drop of water that helps the person who's dying of thirst to come out of this this darkness. And you will be rewarded. People are very receptive to what you have to say. age 75, which is now 76 next year, that'll be your reward. People are open to receive. They need saving. They need your help and guidance. Through your books and teachings.
Son's life will be good, good healthy life will be there, new new promotion, good development, good income. Daughter life also will be better. So for the daughter, after December, if she wanted to start something new, she can able to start. It is positive for the daughter to start new work.
For both of your kids, also good times coming up. As we said before, your daughter can start something new if she wants to. And for your son, there might even be a promotion possible for him.
Grandchildren's life also will be good. Grandchildren's affection, unity also will be good in this period, 75, 76 only.
And also your grandchildren's affection for you, very good. Also their life, very good. So the next
thing. If you wish to travel, traveling situation is there for you. But the traveling after December onwards, this situation is there for you to travel. If you like to move, if you like to travel, go some places, you can go travel.
So if you want to travel or move after December, is okay.
Minor jealous people will be there for you, but you don't need to worry about them. You can easily overcome them in your life. It means if you give any right book, there will be wrong commentary or some kind of jealous asking the questions in a negative way. Situation is there, but you can easily overcome by your truthful words and your messages.
There might be some jealousy towards you, but you can easily overcome that. That's not an issue, won't impact you too much. They might be jealous of your success or what you're writing or not quite understand what you do, but it has no impact on your journey.
Financial success will be there for you. That means 75, 76, new incomes or savings, development in your finance will be there for you. Peaceful and
awesome. Financial success for you. There will be money coming in.
77, 78 also will be good for you. 77, 78, even better situation will be there for you.
77 and 78. Don't forget, sorry, this is running age, right? So that's 76, 77 in Western terminology. Also good years.
This period, the children's will be even success will be there for the children. Even the grandchildren's life also will be good.
So it seems like wonderful times coming up for you. Not only your life is good, but also your children's life is going to be okay, and your grandchildren's life too.
Running some kind of school institution. In this period also, again, chakras opening situation is there for you.
So for the kids going to school, that would be okay. I mean, the grandchildren. For you, is it for the grandchildren, the chakra opening, or for Bill?
No. Grandchildren's relationship will be good. For you, you'll be having a kind of school. It can be as an institute or center.
Okay. So the relationship between you and your grandchildren will be good. But what he's trying to say is you might have some sort of a school where you teach others. Teach others to open chakras, or his chakra will be opened. Shiam.
No, you can help the people to open their chakras. It is your duty to help. It can be meditation way, yoga, or spiritual advisors. You can help others to open their chakras.
So you can help others to open their chakras. It could be through meditation or healing techniques of any sort. That is 77, 78, 76, 77. Coming up in about 2 years from now.
You can use more the third eye chakra intuition, seeing the past, present, future, seeing situation will be the ability in this period will be there for you.
So your third eye chakra will be open and you can see the past, the present, and the future.
In this way, for the wife, some health issues will be there. The health issues connected to bone, digestion, back pain will be there.
But in this period, your wife might get sick, and she might have bone or joint related issues or digestive issues.
In this way also you'll be honored, good honor will be there, awards, rewards, good money, lucky money also will be there for lucky money.
Time, money-wise would be good, awards, rewards, and what they call lucky money is unexpected money coming your way. The ultimate unexpected money is like a lottery win.
It's kind of donation, gift, donation,
whatever. That's lucky money. Lucky money means money that you don't expect and it's given to you.
So in the future, you need to focus your writing. More simplicity is essential. So that means you should not write too long as novel or things. Because in other way, for the lazy people, we need to be more lazy.
So your writings should be
short,
simplified and shortened so that the quote unquote lazy people have access to it and can work with it and digest it and process it. So not long, not complicated, but simplify things.
But it can be more volumes, might be step by step. It can be small book and more volume. Then only they can follow it up and by interest and they can read it. If you do more content, it is chaos for them, it's confused. It is not bearable for them to understand it, understand the real message.
You understand, sir? Just keep it simple so they understand the message. That's the gist of it, really.
That's my style.
Yes.
Someone for the son, some new car. Not only the job, he can also start some business. Business focusing, business starting situation is there for the son. And the daughter with her partner do some kind of cooperation work. Business also 77, 78 possible is there.
So 77, 78, that's your age, obviously. For both of your children, son and daughter, business opportunities can be, are there.
Do finance connected, teaching connected.
Or with her husband.
Spiritual.
It could be a spiritual thing. It could be
finance, teaching, spiritual. These three areas.
It's an opportunity, whether they grab it or not, is up to them, but the windows open up for them. The universe opens up an opportunity to start something new for both.
It is connected to for them fire energy. That means any fire things, fire equipments or spiritual connected, energy connected, teaching connected, finance connected. They can do.
Well, yeah, as we said before, it's connected to either energy healing, teaching, or finance.
So for the wife, some health care is essential in this period, because for the wife, this period, the planet Saturn impact will be there. That means some kind of physical problem, stomach problem, digestion problem may come for the wife in this period.
So you need to be careful. It's some health issues for your wife during this period. So she needs some support, some help.
Up to 79 for it is okay. You can manage. 80, 81, not good for you, sir. 80, 81, health, that means business block. No work, no business. More service only will be there for you. Only guidance and service for others.
So up until 79, you have a smooth ride, basically. And then 80, 81, there will be a slowdown in business and income. So that time should be dedicated to service, like helping others and guidance. And you'd be depending on your pension.
Bone, digestion, kidney, connected to a heart-related problem, also coming situation.
During this time, 80-81, you might have some health issues related to bone, digestion, kidneys, or heart.
No travel. Healthcare is essential in this period. More healthcare.
You shouldn't travel. You should look after your health during this time.
Very good.
For bone related, walking, you should do more walking. From now on, you need to do walking, yoga, exercises, you need to do regularly.
In order to reduce the risk, then in the future, what you need to start doing now is, when it comes to your bones, do some walking, yoga, or exercises to strengthen the bone and to keep your flexibility
going. Oranges, dates, pomegranate, you have to take more. If milk is not allergens, milk you have to take, and egg boiled egg you can take if you or.
And when it comes to nutrition, eat oranges or drink fresh, real orange juice, dates, pomegranate juice. If you have no allergies, then milk is good, or boiled eggs or spinach.
Lentils you can take, boiled lentils you can take, green lentils, boiled lentils, nuts boiled you can take.
Or lentils, you can boil the lentils, green lentils, or also nuts is good for you.
For easy digestion, beans you have for kidney related problem, digestion, beans you have to take. Papaya, banana, you have to take regularly.
For your kidney-related issues, eat beans, papaya, or banana.
For easy digestion, more warm water, you need to drink hot water regularly.
And for your digestion, to have better digestion and easier digestion, you want to drink hot or warm water throughout the day. It really helps a lot.
You can boil in water and drink.
You can boil the cumin seeds and eat them or drink them along your hot or warm water.
And also ginger, you can also add ginger for better digestion. Hello?
Published since my last book because I didn't know what to
write. Maybe we lost.
You're back. We lost to Shyam.
Yes.
But you're back. No, I guess you're not back.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ginger, you have ginger tea.
We lost to Shyam. You froze up on us. Yes. The last thing we heard is the cumin seed, boil the cumin seed. That's it. After that, you need to repeat, please.
You have to take ginger. Ginger, you have to add more in the food. So ginger tea.
Add more ginger to your diet for your digestion. Very important. Ginger tea, fresh ginger, add it to your food. Or make a ginger tea, fresh ginger tea. Just add some hot water to freshly sliced ginger. Or grated ginger.
Weekly once or twice a week, olive oil juice you have to take. Gooseberry you have to use more. Once you can take.
Twice a week, aloe vera juice is good. And gooseberries too.
Yes. Meditation you have to do more, and natural food you have to take. That means you have to avoid salt, sugar, oil. You need to reduce and avoid.
So you should meditate more and also reduce the intake of salt, oil, and sugar. Was it? What was the other one?
Salt, sugar, oil.
Salt, sugar, and oil. Yes, correct. Mm-hmm.
Cholesterol, junk food, cholesterol item, you have to avoid.
Yes, well, obviously you should need the junk food to be.
If you like to take something delicious, sweet or delicious, you can take. Doesn't mean you should not take. Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday, you can take what you like.
Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays, you get the carte blanche, so to speak. You can indulge a little bit. And
can be meat if you like meat. You can take.
That's not so good for you, like meat and sweets and stuff. On Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays, not overindulge, but at least you can have some. If you need to have some comfort food, then do it on Sunday. Tuesday or Thursday.
It's like a feast. You can take something party feast. You can take heavy food. You can take on this. And Monday, Wednesday, Friday, medicinal day. You need to use medicines on this medicinal food.
So Monday, the other days should be medicinal foods that you take. Healing foods only.
Healing food. It can be vegetable, more adding vegetables, fruits, diet, or herbs connected, medicine connected, which is the good for health. We need to focus Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And Saturday, it's a relaxation, oil bath, oil massage, relaxation day for Saturday.
So basically, you got 3 days where you can indulge a little bit. That's Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday. Yes. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, you need to be very strict and really only focus on quote-unquote medicinal foods that are good for you and only good for you. And the Saturday is like your day off of either one of the two. Is the relaxation day. Get a massage, oil rubs, you know, something that's good for the body and the soul. Hot bath, I guess, steam bath, anything that's good for you and the body.
AC81 not good for some kind of troublesome and some major health issues, major health problem will be there. But by your natural healthcare, you can be able to manage. 82, 83, 84, you can able to overcome these problems in your life. But rest, 82 to 84, rest will be there for you. Rest.
So, you know, as the reason why we tell you all these things is 80, 81 will be health-wise challenging years for you, dangerous years. In order to not be as much in danger, you really need to start changing your diet now, do more exercise and do the things that are recommended to you. So once you've overcome the challenging years, 80, 81, 82 to 84 will be smooth waters again. But these are also times for you to rest. Rest means no work.
Yes. 85, 86,
some health issues will be there for you again, sir.
And 85, 86, you'll have again health issues.
The same period for the partner, wife. Earlier, there is a problematic situation for the wife is that your age of 77 to 79, I mean 78, 79 for the wife. But again, the final 85, 86 for the wife, not good.
So also, when your health issues come back, 85, 86, the same time for the wife, not good. She'll also have health issues during the time.
If you overcome this 85, 86 means until 88, 89, the longevity will be there in this life for you, sir. Long life up to 88, 89, longevity.
If you are able to survive and overcome this period of 85, 86 with your health issues, then you're given the gift of longevity past 88, 89. Which means it cannot really determine your age bracket of death anymore, but you reach 88, 89, plus a day or plus several more years.
It's we talked about the four dot. The fifth dot will open when you try to unite with five elements. There are five elements. You need to connect somehow the five elements in your life, sir.
If you overcome this and if you're able to connect with the five elements, the fifth dot that we talked about, that's... can open up for you. So obviously fire.
The fire element is first, you're strong because Leo, Sagittarius, fire element for you. Pisces, water element for you. That means second element. But the other element, by meditation, you can balance sky with the divine blessing, land, which connected to land healing or mud healing. With connecting with the land with you, you can balance the energy. So land.
Your two main elements are fire because of your astrology that we told you before, Leo and Sagittarius, and water is the second element for you because of you being a Pisces. Mm-hmm. And somehow you need to connect with these five elements, fire, water, air, what is the other one? Land and the sky.
Meditation, prayer, yoga, and dhyana. It is the best way to reach it, dhyana.
And obviously the easiest way would be through meditation and prayer, yoga, dhyana.
By fulfilling this task in this life, by fulfilling your spiritual work, social work, services, and doing the services, moksha will be there. After this life, you go for have moksha. Liberation will be there for you. You can get enlightenment and liberation.
Wow, so this is what you can achieve. For you. What you can achieve is this being your last life. When you pass on, you reach enlightenment and moksha.
Already there is an enlightenment, there is a knowledge. Enlightenment already is received, partially the enlightenment received for you. You already received the enlightenment. So you have the capability of enlightenment. You already which you are already deserved or achieved the enlightenment, which is now. And liberation, which happens after this life, after you're passing away, liberation, moksha will be.
So it seems that you've already achieved enlightenment now, this lifetime. In the previous years, and you can also reach liberation. Liberation is once you have passed on and entered moksha with the eternal source.
But after your life also, your name, fame will be preserved by your writings. By your teachings will be preserved among the people. There is a good value things which we call as a dharma. So which is the dharma we are going to preserve in this life? Righteousness, the good righteousness, or it's a kind of light energy which you can able to preserve. It can be your knowledge. Body couldn't.
You mean once Bill has passed on, his name will be preserved, and
your physical body will not be preserved in this universe for a longer period, but your writings, your knowledge, teachings will be preserved for the future in all people's life who follow you.
Even though you will pass on at some point in the future, and your physical body won't last forever, but your teachings. Your books will continue to live.
More connected to life-oriented, you need to coach. Life coaching, life training, it's a kind of life coaching, which is related to life. You can do spiritual writing also, you can do spiritual writing and about the values, human values, developing the humanity. Bringing the unity and love. Unity and love bringing, you need to write.
What is good for you is to do some life coaching, spiritual coaching, writing, talking about the unity of humans, love, the eternal love and love between humans. That's your path.
Unity not within the country, sir. It is the unity is not within the country. The unity is within one person with another person, one country with another country. So you need to bring a mass, a global unity. We talk about the global unity, the mass bigger unity from all countries being unity as one nation, one country, like it's oneness in God. So motto, there is a motto to bring the unity in oneness with all.
Did you understand, sir? So it's more the bigger picture when it comes to unity. It's the oneness of all countries. We're one country, we're one nation, we're one human race. So focusing on the bigger picture in your spiritual writings.
You already have some ability to see the future related to disasters, dangers, problems. You already have the picture, bigger picture to see the future. You can also advise, giving an intimation for the people in time.
Do you understand, sir? Basically, we're repeating. So you already have the wisdom. You already have the knowledge. Just expand on it, really, in short.
Not only there is a no particular religion can follow Hinduism, it can follow Sikh, it can follow Buddha, Buddhism, it can follow Christianity. So we can learn more things from all and make a new universal religion. That means universal spiritual path for him.
You don't necessarily need to follow a particular religion. You can connect with all of them, Buddhism, Hinduism, you know, Christianity and so forth. You can distill the essence out of all of them and then bring about the wisdom that's within all of them to the bigger mass.
So after this life, moksha will be there. Not only for you, we see as the wife. Wife is also have a divine energy, angel. So for her also, moksha will be there. But your children deserving your level a bit weaker will be there. So, but by your guidance and help, there is some possibility.
Okay, so that's amazing news. Not only will you reach moksha, which is nirvana, but as they can see, also your wife, because she carries angelic energies in her too. But when it comes to your kids, they cannot see it yet. They're not as evolved as you are. But through your guidance and help and support, they might reach that as well. So there is the potential. There is a potential for them to get there too.
The grandchildren will get your knowledge, sir. The children is weak, but your grandchildren, because your knowledge, your ability for the grandchildren will be there. But children's weak. But for the grandchildren, it will reach the generation. Energetic transformation for the grandchildren will be the grandson. One of the grandson will be doing your path of spiritual work also, chances is there.
Even though the passing on of your wisdom and knowledge to your kids weak at the moment a little bit, the connection with the grandchildren and their development is strong. So what they can see is that one of your grandsons can continue your work or be in the same realm as you are in now. So the grandchildren, even though they're kids now, they have already a higher chance of reaching moksha than your kids because they're a little more evolved than your own kids.
So whenever you have possibility, you
need to overcome the generational gap to connect with the grandchildren.
There is a saint, is a king who later on changed as a saint who served in China, Bodhi Dharma. You can read about you, sir, because you are somehow connected with this Bodhi Dharma.
So there is a former king converted into a saint, a Bodhi Dharma. He's tapped into your chat history, which you will get from us anyway.
Yes, he's from India, originally from India, but he did some service in China. He's from Tamil Nadu, but he did service in China.
Okay, he was originally from Tamil Nadu, southern parts of India.
But he taught the self-defense and spiritual, Ayurveda, the medicinal things, self-defense, self-protection.
So Mokkavarma
means
attracting
ability. Attracting someone. So it's a kind of therapy or healing he did.
So he could also, he was a leader. He taught Ayurvedic medicine and self-defense, but he could also heal people through his eyes.
Are you talking about my grandson or me?
No, we're talking about this Bodhidharma guy. You need to do some research on him because Guruji discovered that you're somehow connected to this guy called Bodhidharma, originally from India.
There's a connection
between you and Bodhidharma, correct, yes.
Okay. Because the same face, same eyes, same beard, same. So when you see about him, he can connect with you. The same energy is reserving as a reflection. You can see. So
You look like him. Like the same facial features, beard, you know, head, and when you see a picture of him, you can tell that there is a connection between you and him.
For you also, like him, for you also, you'll be, he preserve the good things, teachings and rational. In the future, you can also preserve like this in the future. Like him, you can deserve something in this life, in this universe. Good days for yourself. Sunday and Thursday and Saturday, good days for you.
Three days in the week are good days for you. If you want to do something that's more important, then do it on a Sunday, Thursday, or Saturday.
You see that? East direction, south direction, good direction for you.
East and south direction are good directions.
Once you hold the third element is fire, the second element is water element for you.
So your elements are fire and water, obviously.
Ruby, yellow, sapphire, good lucky gems for yourself. Ruby, yellow, sapphire.
Gems, the gems that are good for you, ruby and yellow, sapphire.
So you can carry them. Black is not that much positive for you.
Excuse me?
Your wearing side is wearing black, so black is not good. So white, yellow, red is more positive.
So you wearing black is not so good for you energetically, but white, yellow, and what's the other one? Ruby, you said?
Yellow, red, and white. This
yellow, red, and white will be good colors for you to wear. Yellow, red, and white.
Good lucky gems, ruby and yellow, sapphire, that you can wear. It is a positive. Pearl also you can wear.
So pearls, ruby, or yellow sapphire are good gems for you, either to wear or to carry them with you in your pocket or have them somewhere in the house, because the energies are good for you in general.
Good lucky number, lucky it is 1, 2, 3, 9 other lucky numbers, just have them in time.
And your lucky numbers, which Yam is typing into the chat now, are 1, 2, 3, 9 and several more coming up. These are the days of the month. So every month, these days are good days for you. For when you travel or, you know, sign a contract or give a speech or whatever, if it's one of those days, it's better for you. Or you play the lottery, you want to use one of those numbers, obviously. So these are your lucky numbers. 12 times a year, every month.
Okay, Maharishi, MC Operation Sir, if you have any question, you can ask now.
So now we've reached the end of your prediction, sir. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask.
Wow, where to begin? I'm speechless. I had questions, but I kind of feel like I have to be here for the next few years for my grandchildren. That was my thought coming into this thing, because I really do believe that my grandchildren are going to carry on my energy. Is that my imagination?
No, you were told that they will. Yes.
Yeah, because it's like I'm here for them more so than for my own children. It's like they're inheriting whatever I got to give them, energy, knowledge, whatever I have. So that's good to get a confirmation on that. And for you guys, for feedback, I published my last book, this book, which I was told in my last Nadi to write. So I wrote that one. and then I had all these thoughts, like I wanted to write another book, but I had things that were holding me back. Like I can't say that. I don't want to. Until this week, when I started my new book yesterday, before this reading, and talking about the pandemic, talking about the future, talking about getting out of this 30-year cycle of bad stuff coming. I mean, everything you said that I should write about is what I got in my outline for my new spiritual book, which just, I was sitting there listening to that, kind of keeping my mouth shut, but it was basically you were telling me to do what I'm actually doing. And I was waiting, and I needed to know it was right to go. And then this week I go, it's time to start. It's time to do it.
Yes, sir. Yes.
It was funny, it was because I don't know if I sent it to you, Dr. Q, but I start off, I built a book cover for it. It's I Still Remember Tomorrow. And it's got my foot. But people think, well, that's, no, it's really true. It's about remembering tomorrow. And anyway, that's my book's kind of about. And hopefully I will keep it like you say. Also, my style of reading is little short true stories about experiences and things, but keeping them short so you can read a little bit and walk away and come back to it and read another one. It's all because people's attention span is nothing. This generation has no attention span and they don't want to. So I'm trying to keep things simple. I don't use big words. I keep it simple.
Yes.
Anyway, background. So I was coming into this thing concerned about a couple of things. I had a Nadi reading 10 years ago and it only went to 2020. It stopped, right? So it was like it was a death. And basically I was told that I would get an extension if that's what Lord Shiva wanted to do, or Babaji, then only that, only if I was gonna be doing continued work, but it wasn't my choice. So when I was going into this reading, I was kind of going, well, are they even gonna find anything? Because the last one ended here. So it's kind of nice to know. And I had that feeling yesterday, and that's why I started my new book, because I wasn't starting it because I didn't know how much time I had. Now I got a feeling that I will finish this next book and I got another one planned after that. So I've been kind of holding back on my teaching and holding back on, you know, expressing all I want to express. Yes, and there's jealousy out there and there's negative and there's all that stuff. But I reached a point now that that's not an issue anymore because I don't care. I'm at that age and I don't care what they think. I have a message. I'm going to deliver that message, whether it's on YouTube videos or if it's in books or public talks. And so I think your reading is kind of telling me, yeah, that's what you're supposed to do. So I appreciate that. And as far as questions for the future, everything I wanted to know, I think you kind of covered. My only concerns at this point in my life is, what can I do for my grandchildren? What can I do?
In simple way, you should not do anything specifically for your children and grandchildren. But children's will not change. The children's, whatever they do, is an error. But grandchildren will copy. What you need to do, the presence of you, that means what you wanted to say or give the message for them, if you act upon it according to that, they will observe you. They will observe your attitude. They will observe your character. They will observe your message. So you need to spend the time. The most important to spend the time, whenever you go outside, you can take them, they can observe your keen observation of your attitude, your work, your service, your message, your knowledge, and they copy it and they follow according to that. It makes the life. So if you give any advices, it is a temporary. If you give advice, it comes temporary knowledge and forgetfulness. But when they see and copy it, it comes preserved as a footprint, like a memory in their mind. So they follow for a longer period, the change.
So teach them through example, living my life.
Yes.
Be the example, yes, for them to copy.
But it is good. For the grandchildren, the next 1.5 is very pretty good. Pretty good will be there for the grandchildren. So it is good. Their relationship also will be good. Children's life also, the next 1.5 years will be good. So after 41 days, no problem. It is good for the children's as well.
Do you have any other questions, sir?
I have a simple philosophy of life, and it's always been to love and serve. And I've always felt that's my dharma, my purpose.
Dharma, yes, dharma.
And I've done it at different levels, but this last decade, this last several years, it's been foremost. It's been the most powerful message I got about forgiving others, loving. I just gave a talk on an Indian blog the other day talking about we got to forget about borders. we got to forget about race, religion. We're all one family. We're all one united people.
Same message given by Margaret. Yes, it's true. Because you need to think not only in your country, your people. It can be different country as a oneness in nation, oneness in your world, oneness in unity. Yes, it's true.
Oneness. So this has just reaffirmed, believe it or not, what I kind of felt already. You're telling me stuff that at a level I go, yeah, but you don't know if it's ego, and you would kind of set the ego aside, but it's like, no, yes. You're affirming what I deeply already not believe, but know. And there's a difference between believing and knowing. And that's kind of where I'm at now. Dr. Q, what kind of question should I ask? You've been around. I'm thinking I need to meditate. If I was a doctor like Dr. Q, I'd say meditate more, embrace your karma, help others embrace theirs, love, serve, teach people to forgive, and it all works out. And eat your vegetables. And we're all right. Yeah. So,
yes. You're on the right path anyway. Your reading confirmed that you are on the correct path, that you're in alignment with what you're supposed to be doing. Will there be health challenges? Yes, but you were told what you can do already now to help reduce the impact. You were told that the reading showed you that you should be focusing on the teachings and simplify them so people can understand what the message is and pass on your knowledge, not just to the general public, but help your grandchildren. And basically you're given another, God willing, 15 years, you know, a lot more time, given the health challenges you had. This is an incredible blessing.
I've had 12 major heart attacks in my life. I've had major health issues.
Yes.
And
amazing.
So reaching 2020 was not for certain.
Yes.
So it's.
But you did.
But
you
did. Getting extra time was never about me or what I could accomplish. It's always been about, there are people out there, if you see it on there, let me know, but it's like, there are people waiting for me. This is what, there are people waiting for me because they need what I'm going to give them.
Yes, that is true.
And it's not coming from me, it's flowing through me, it's not mine. I don't own it. Yes. I'm only a pipe that this energy, this love, this
energy flowing, whatever it is true.
Is flowing, you know, the pipe is not the knowledge. The pipe is just letting it flow. I'm just a pipe. It's flowing. Does that make sense?
Yes, yes.
So somehow it is going by you, sir, because there is a transformation, as the reading told. It is channeling. There was a block, but it is started again. The channeling again started for it. The last 30 days again started this. The next 1.5, that means 17 months, again more channeling will be there by you. It will reach the people. That means somehow you need to save the people, you know? So like lifting their hand, so catching their hand, lifting it up, you know, saving them, like the situation, the duties for the next 17 months is connected to this pandemic.
Well, it's interesting things are going on that I've ignored. I have people contacting me on the internet. They watch my video or they read my book and they swear that they got healed by reading my words or watching me talk. Or they dreamt that I was there healing them in their dreams, or I was actually there. And I go to sleep at night and I go into these death-like trance sleeps. I don't remember nothing. But I get people from all around the world saying, you were here last night. You talked to me. You stopped the suicide. You did this and that. So I don't know whether that's craziness on the world's part and if people are delusional, which is possible. Or there's something really happening when I'm sleeping and I'm working outside of this physical body that I'm in when I'm sleeping or should be sleeping. Is that even possible? Have you ran into that
possible, before? Sir, that means you no need to activate related to physically to help someone, but by your energy can help someone. It can be by through your message, by your words, by your writings, and also through your light or energy, because you have a stronger energy, which is it is coming out from your body, because you have two fire, not one fire. Fire means fire energies, two fire, but somehow it is balancing the energy by the water. So two fire, that is two fire. Somehow the energy is balancing by water. That's why you have a smooth guidance, but you need to go in general, your energy is transforming very fire, very fast. Fire energy is blowing very fast. Fire means knowledge, light, energy, healing, guidance. So in a very fast, but somehow you are giving with water, combined with water, it makes soft energy. So it is not harsh, it's not painful, but it is going in a mild, like the message to heal others.
Explains a lot, but in a strange way, you're only confirming. It's technically you're not supposed to do your own reading, but I've already kind of read this already last week. What you're telling me is just, it's like deja vu. It's like, okay.
Yes, deja vu.
I know exactly where you're going.
Deja vu.
Yes,
you're right, sir. It is deja vu. As it is also the reading mentions that you have the possibility to past, present, future telling, you know, intimation, what is going to have, disaster, pandemic, troubles, problem. You have any intimation to give the message in advance for the people. Deja vu in advance will be there for you.
Okay. Dr. Q, thank you.
Thank you, sir. I guess we're going to move on to the puja reading now. Just going to listen to what Guruji tells us, and I will explain you the pujas afterwards, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Velamidavin, Guru Dhanamai.
At first, the Guru Dhan, Guru Dhan, Guru Dashna, to Guruji Jaira, she had to give a kind of Guru Dhan donation. Then you have to give Guru Dhan to Indian Palm Pudding Institute in terms of showing the gratitude. It can be by your salaries, guiding the people, helping the people for this institute. You need to show your gratitude from the Indian Palm Institute. After that, you need to do prayer for Ganesha. Ganesha prayer to remove the blocks, especially there is health block and finance. So to remove your health block and financial block to make it better, health and finance. Other thing is good. Your life is good, the health and finance to remove the block. 6 Sundays you need to pray for Ganesha. By Thursdays, we will puja for Guru. Guru Darshanamurti prayer. It is for the children, for the kids. Darshanamurti. Guru Darshanamurti. For the children's good health, good career, good development, good relationship with you. 5 Thursdays, pray for Guru. There will be some kind of negative people, jealous also in your surrounding. To avoid them, 7 Fridays, the puja for Durga. Durga prayer, you have to do. For 7 Fridays and full moon day, you need to pray for Shiva and Parvati. 5 full moon day at last for the spiritual success and development. Shiva and Parvati for the 5 full moon day, you have to do. These are the temple puja that you need to do in order. There is some spiritual duties and social service in this life you need to do. Social service you need to do for people, helping the people, guiding the people in the spiritual direction. It can be meditation, yoga, or palm leaf consultation, talking about palm leaf and guiding the people for palm leaf, spiritual work, or your energy work, energy healing. But the most important for the people, for the faith, you know, the faith healing, energy healing, that means belief, faith healing, developing the confidence, removing the ignorance, removing the fearness. So when there is a fearness is removed, that means the faith is inbuilt in that one. So that you need to do in the future. Spiritual duty and guidance you have to do. So these are the pujas that you need to do in your life. So this is the end of your prayer and pujas. Well,
is there no mantra puja?
No, no. So there is no karma, no mantra puja, no other blocks.
Okay, wow. Okie dokie.
So there is no big block for you. So there is, we don't see a bigger block. Maybe there is a block for 41 days. So by the prayer, you can able to only, you need to connect with yourself. You need to connect with the supreme energy. And there is, you need to try to connect with other elements. There are two elements is positive, fire and water. You need to try to connect with other elements, land, sky, and air. So you can balance by meditation. That means doing more practice in meditation, connecting yourself with land. You can do.
Okay. I'll explain all that to you, sir. Do you have any final words or questions before we say bye-bye to our beloved Guruji, our senior reader, and Shyam, our office manager and senior
interpreter? Yeah, what was the name of the, behind you, those? Are they the same person behind you, same saint, both those portraits?
Oh, he's talking about the god behind you, Shyam.
Is that the same?
Sarasvati is on from our point of view, on the left side is Sarasvati.
Murugan, the god who brings the good fortune, knowledge, and family, like partner, Murugan.
They're two different gods, sir.
Okay, god.
Sarasvati left, Lord Murugan right.
There is Sarasvati's blessing is there, sir. There is the god of Sarasvati's blessing is there for you. So today,
yes, connected, sir. Yes.
So when we do prayer, sir, when you do prayer, usually if the flower is falling down, means we have the blessing. So when we do when we are doing the flower which was tied was fell down. So we were telling some message and we felt, yes, that there is a blessing for you.
Correct. Yes.
It was a symbol. It is a good symbol. So.
Okay.
Because the gods doesn't appear in a physical form, but through the energy, we can feel that energy here. So it's falling down, and there's a blessing when telling your messages.
Mm-hmm.
That's why during the reading, it was told. When it was falling, the flower was falling, we mentioned that the Saraswati's blessing is there for you.
Do you understand? Do you understand, sir? Bill, while they were doing the reading and they were giving you a special message,
The flower fell off. No, I was actually watching. I was staring at it. Maybe it was my problem. Maybe I'm sorry.
No, it happened.
I was staring at it, and as I was focused on it, and then I kind of didn't want to call the attention. I thought, what happened? You know. So I'm sorry. I apologize for messing up your flowers, but it was. I was just staring at that corner up there, and it went. So. Sorry.
No. That's a good sign.
It's a good sign. It's a good sign for your blessing. It's a blessing from the goddess, Saraswati blessing.
But it was interesting. My first reading that I got 10 years ago, everything they predicted about me happened. There's nothing left to happen. That's why I was kind of going. So I thought the only thing left was had to be death, right? So,
yes.
But I kind of feel like in my own way that I'm passing into a new phase, that there is kind of a spiritual rebirth death here going on. It's like this year, I'm changing. That makes sense?
Yes. That
I've reached this point and I'm dumping it. It's like that was yesterday. 2021 or the next 41 days from now, I feel I'm new, I'm different. I'm not the same as I was the last 10 years. I mean this literally. I feel like death and rebirth in a process right now. And that's what, yes, I've been feeling. I'm feeling like, well, if I get through into December a little later, I was good. And now you're saying 41 days, which is just kind of like in the same ballpark. But I had that feeling that no, this too shall pass. This is, it's like changing your clothing. Still me, but I'm not the same.
Mm.
It's different.
Yes.
That's crazy talk. I'm sorry. This is no,
beautiful.
It's
thank you.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
It is what it is. I feel blessed that you've confirmed my own personal inner reading and given me a good affirmative look at my grandchildren, because to me,
the grandchildren will be there. Sir.
That is my main reason to be here. I mean, there's the bigger scope, but I mean, on a personal level,
yes,
bringing my grandchildren the gift of whatever I got is all, it's what motivates me to keep going.
Yes.
So it's interesting. So I live my life a certain way, and I could give that example to my grandchildren, and that will affect their children and their grandchildren. Yes,
correct.
Because I've changed them in some way. So it's, when you're saying things live on, yeah, they do. And it's not just genetics, it's spiritual DNA, the most important genetics of all. So I am feeling very light right now. My spine is tingling.
Yes, you're right, sir, because your genetic can help more the grandchildren, sir. You can expect grandchildren will be much successful like you.
I am very, very, very pleased and honored to have them in my family. But I'll tell you what, there's a lot of people out there that they're not family, they're not blood relatives, but they're family as well. And there's a lot of people that I feel a need to be there for. So it's good to know that I'll be able to extend my services, whatever they may be. Let's get real. Nothing is us. It's all from the one source.
Yes.
And if we're lucky enough to be blessed to be used in some way or manner, that's a blessing to be used.
You're from a good source. You're an angel. That means, as my reading told, either you, your wife, is a source of angel. Then from the angelic energy is for you or for the wife. It is already mentioned in the lead, because the reason why we told like this means, even though there is lots of block, it doesn't affect you. That means you have the ability to protect. It is beyond the human level. So you're not in a human level. You're reached already there. Beyond the human level. That's why the blocks doesn't affect you and your wife.
Bless the both of you. And I humbly thank you. Keep up the work. I'm trying to help Dr. Q here, because he contacted me after people told him about me. But when he contacted me, I intuitively knew, no, I'm supposed to help him. Because he is helping preserve, protect, project, and educate people on what you're doing.
Yes.
And this needs to be done. So if any way this helps Dr. Q, my testimony is out there, and I'm attesting that this reading for me was 100% accurate. Not from a, I guess it feels right. No, it's from a knowing that this was exactly correct. Whole different level.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'll let you guys go back and do your job.
Thank you, Koji. Thank you, Shyam.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Bless the day. Thank you. Namaste. Nandri.
Namaste.
Bye-bye.